Shih Tzu puppy's first trim. This is our follow-up video to Shih Tzu puppy's first bath. Learning to groom your pet has never been easier.
Guys, this is Roscoe's first groom. Roscoe is a Shih Tzu puppy, and he is only almost 12 weeks old. It's nice to get them in at this age because at 3 months old, Roscoe doesn't require a lot of trimming. So that's awesome because we're slowly going to wean him into the grooming process.
Let's review part one of Roscoe's first groom. If you haven't watched that video, there's a link in the card above as well as a link in the description below. In part one, we gave Roscoe a sanitary trim as well as trimmed his nails, and we gave him a good bath. There's some awesome bathing secrets in that demo, guys. I also showed you how to clean Roscoe's ears as well as give him an amazing fluff dry up on the grooming table. I want you to know that it's very important to start working with your puppy about 3 months old and no later to get them used to the grooming process, especially if you're planning to take them to a professional groomer to have their grooming needs met. Familiarizing them with their groomer as well as grooming tools, product, equipment is very crucial at this age. And hey, smash that like button if this is the video you've been waiting for, because it is absolutely my pleasure to share the secrets of the grooming industry with you, my friend. Let's begin.
Today, I'm just going to be trimming around his eyes, a little bit around his face, not much, with a scissors and a thinning shear. We are going to trim out these little paw pads. As you can see, they have a lot of hair in them. I'm going to trim his paw pads, and I'm going to scissor the feet. He's going to get a good bath, too. Trimming around his hiney and cleaning that up for him. Everything else for a puppy groom is just simply light trimming, bathing, and brushing. So it's just going to ease him into the process.
I start by trimming the hair away from his eyes, and at the stop, we're opening up his visor so he can see the world, and most importantly, so you can see his beautiful face. I'm using a Jody Murphy thinning shears. I will link all the products and tools used in this demo in case you guys are interested. Go check them out. This is a puppy trim, and there's not a whole lot that I need to take off right now. But stay tuned, because here in a second, I'm going to show you another fantastic use for a thinning shear, scissor over comb, that I'm going to utilize on Roscoe. But right now, I want you to notice that I am actually holding Roscoe under his chin. By his hair, not aggressively. I am holding Roscoe in place, and he is performing very well for me. This tells him what I want him to do, and having my hands on him is so important because it lets him know what he needs to do. Now let's take a look. We've opened up those eyes for Roscoe, and he can see so much better, but we can see him much better. Now we're gonna trim the visor, kind of his bangs. We're trimming that from the corner of one eye to the corner of the other eye. That is the brow area. Now we're going to flip that ear back and thin down his cheek and just create sort of a rounded cheek that comes down into his jaw. I'm also thinning the hair down right in front of his ear. This is just to help vent the ear and keep airflow to get in there. He doesn't develop any ear problems, hopefully not. Now take notice, I'm still using my thinning shear. I am really going to perform this whole trim on Roscoe with the thinning shear because it just handles the puppy coat so beautifully and it looks so natural, especially when you take advantage of this scissoring technique. This is the scissor over comb technique that I was talking about earlier. Look how it just helps me blend Roscoe's coat. Now I'm starting from the back of his skull, the base of his skull, and just blending forward towards his visor and into his cheek. This is a completely different scissoring technique than I would use with a straight shear. I'm using a thinning shear to round the shape of his head, the top of his head, underneath his jaw. I am using this thinning shear instead of a scissor, but I'm using it like a scissor. Now we're gonna round in this jaw into his cheek. And remember, because we're grooming Roscoe at 3 months old, there's not a whole lot that we need to take off, which is easier on Roscoe. Now let's round in that foot.
Looking at the front of his foot, we're just creating a U shape, and we're going to bring that U shape straight up into his leg.
I'm using a thinning shear for this just because it looks so natural, but you could certainly use a straight shear. Now we're going to hold that leg out as if he was taking a step, and we're just trying to blend that foot into the leg. So it all looks like it flows nice. You know, he is a puppy, so we don't have to get too crazy with our trimming here. They only have this puppy coat for a short time, so let's enjoy this soft, bouncy, beautiful coat. Now be careful back here around the pads, and also there's a knuckle back here above his foot on the back of his leg. I want you to always be aware of that. When I trim the under part of a dog's paw at their pads, I go all the way around it with my scissor in a whole 360, if that makes sense, because I do not want my shears to be laying straight across the pad. And as far as blending in his chest and his leg and the body, it's just so easy to blend with a thinning shear. Now let's clean up the sanitary area. I'm using a number 10 blade, guys. I wouldn't suggest anything shorter, and I wouldn't suggest anything longer. I would use a number 10 in a sanitary area, even the pads of the feet. And that's not just because he is a puppy. That goes for any dog. Puppies definitely have sensitive skin. These areas that we're trimming right now are very sensitive. The skin is very tender. So a 10 blade is gentle enough and safe. I like to clean this area up to about the belly button, which is just above his little pee-pee. Now I'm going to show you how I blend in that clipper work into my body trim. I use a thinning shear. You could use a straight shear, but as you can see with this puppy coat, it just blends beautifully with a thinning shear. And this area back here, we need to keep clean because we know how quickly the puppy coat will grow, and we know we do not want feces to be collecting back here. So we're just trying to blend it together. Now we're gonna blend that rump hair right down into his leg hair. It's very easy to do with a puppy coat. It just lays beautifully. And remember, we like them to look fluffy and bouncy and full. We don't need to take a lot off of this little baby today. And it's very important that we allow him to have his puppy coat for a little while because it won't be here long. So once again, at 3 months old, this was the perfect time for us to get our baby Shih Tzu in for a trim, because all we had to trim really was his face, his feet, and his privates. So let's take a look at you now, Roscoe.
Let's share some trivia in the comments below. Here's the question. Why do non-shedding breeds still lose hair? Throw your answer in the comments section. Let's get chatty.
And don't forget to go back and watch part one of this tutorial, which was Roscoe's bath. Don't forget to smash that subscribe button so you don't miss anything.